It's New York's turn to pay homage to General Jonathan Wainwright with a typical paper shower blanketing the motorcade as it winds up Lower Broadway. More than 4 million people line the streets to scream their tribute to the hero of Corregidor and Bataan, the man who held off the Japs so long and went down fighting. Hiya, Skinny, and God bless you, Skinny, were frequent shouts as thankful New Yorkers put on one of the greatest welcomes in the city's history. More than 300,000 jammed City Hall Park for ceremonies that confer further honors on the man who can tell firsthand of the horrors of those days that followed Corregidor's fall. The general is also made an honorary citizen of New York. In his invasion of the city, he captured the hearts of the people. A grateful nation will never forget you, General. Years of barbarous imprisonment are ending for these deliriously happy Yanks at Nissan Hill Camp outside Tokyo. Freedom is near as Navy shoreboats approach the bombed-out flour mill stockade, which was their prison for weary months in barracks not fit for animals. At Camp Omori, also near Tokyo, the experience is repeated as rescuers near. It has been a long and cruel wait under Jap brutality and starvation. And when an officer tells them you're going home, you can judge for yourselves how they feel. The Japs have been beaten, but this we can never forget.
A star-shaped crater marks the New Mexican desert near Alamogordo, where the first atomic bomb was tested. The crystallized sand has the appearance of green glass. Press representatives get a personally conducted tour by General Groves, chief of the atomic bomb development. Canvas shoe coverings protect the investigators from any remaining radioactive rays, here being registered by radiation meters. Tanks heavily insulated with lead were used to inspect the area just after the blast, and instruments detected a dense volume of deadly radioactive rays. Guards on observation towers served to keep off the curious, and another tower suspended the bomb 100 feet above ground. This is all that remains. The rest of the steel was vaporized. With General Groves is Dr. Oppenheimer, who coordinated the scientific work on the development. A project which opens up a new era for mankind. Credentials are carefully checked by the police at the final session of Vidkun Quisling's trial for treason. The traitor arrives from jail in a police van for the hearing in the Court of Justice. This infamous man, who claims to have saved Norway from becoming a battlefield, fawned at the feet of Hitler and other Nazis, something he couldn't deny. Entering the prisoner's box, he's seated next to his attorney and flanked by guards. For 3 days and nights, seven judges and jurors deliberated before bringing in the verdict, death before the firing squad. Thus, the man whose name became a synonym for traitor will pay for betraying his country.